Hello and welcome back. Here is an interesting question by one of our website visitors. Thank you for providing such valuable tutorials for Excel. I was wondering if there is a way this task can be accomplished. I'm trying to access a website URL that requires username and password. I have to enter my credentials every time I access this site. Is there a way to create a macro or VBA that I can run to make the process quicker? If so, can you please demonstrate how I can get this accomplished? I sincerely appreciate your help. Okay, let's take an example. Let's see how we can log into, for example, Gmail automatically using Excel VBA. So I'll minimize this first. Now we will go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and I've already created the code which I'm going to show you. So there it is. First we define the HTML document, then we define our browser because we are going to use Internet Explorer. Our subroutine name is my Gmail. Then we define two variables, my HTML element, because that is what we'll search for. The elements will be the input text box and the password text box, isn't it? So once we find that, we will then click on the submit button. So then we define also my URL as string, that is our website, and that URL is initialized to Gmail. Then we set the browser to a new Internet Explorer. My browser.silent just means that it will stop pop-ups and things like that. We will navigate to our URL, and when we navigate, we want our browser to be visible. Then we will loop through the document, that is the Gmail document that we find, and we will look for the email text box and the password text box, and there we will put our email address and our password. Okay. After that, once that is done, we will try to find the submit button, and once that is clicked, we will exit the for loop here. Okay, and then we will end the subroutine. Now I'll explain a little bit more, but first I need to show you how this works. Okay, so now I have put in my true password also, and I'm going to run this by clicking on the run button, and there you see automatically it has logged. Sometimes when you run this code, you might encounter silly errors. So to avoid those errors, we can add a few lines of code that will clear those errors. Okay, so I'm going to add those lines of code here on error, go to error clear. If error not zero, then error dot clear resume next end if. So this is how we can ignore some of the errors that happen. Okay. Now what are the other necessary things to do when you implement this code? So the first thing you should do is Gmail. So this is how you will see your Gmail, and these are the two boxes where you need to input the data, isn't it? So you will see the source for this. So let me show you that source. There it is. And now here you can see that the label for email, where you input the type email, that is email, and the label for password is password. Okay, that is what we have used also. So this is how you get to write these two lines of code here. HTML doc.all.email value, and this is how you access those labels. The other important thing that you have to do is that you got to go to tools here, references, and then you have to select Microsoft Internet Controls. You may have to scroll because once you select it, this comes up. Similarly, you have to select Microsoft HTML Object Library. So these are two important things to select when you're going to use the code I have given. Also, I'll put this code on the website so that you can copy it and use it. Okay. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.